thousand generation. We've been called for to show His excellence. Hey, all I require for life, God has given me, and I know who I am. We are a chosen generation. We've been called for to show His excellence. For today, the topic the Lord gave me, distinguishing mothers from murderers. Look to a woman next to you and ask her, are you a mother or are you a murderer? So that we begin to know now. Are you a mother or are you a murderer? Praise the Lord. Quickly, because I know I haven't got much time, but the Lord has no doubt, but the Lord will help us today in Jesus' name. The scripture we'll be reading from the book of Genesis chapter 2 verses 1 to 3, quickly, in the name of Jesus Christ. Genesis chapter 2 verses 1 to 3. Genesis 2, 1 to 3. If there's a fast reader in the house, I don't mind working with the person working with me. I would appreciate it.
Because the heavens and the earth and all the hosts of them were finished. And on the seventh day, God ended his works which he had done. And he rested on the seventh day from all his works which he had done. Then God blessed the seventh day and sanctified it.
That's not what I'm looking for. No. Two.
Genesis 2:1-3.
Okay. Anyway. The portion of the Bible, I probably wrote it wrongly, but I will read it out to you. And the man of the house, I guess it's 22. And the man of the house of Levi went and took as wife a daughter of Levi. So the woman conceived and bore a son. And when she saw he was a beautiful child, she hid him 3 months. She what? She hid him 3 months. But when she could no longer hide him, she took an ark of bulrush for him and daubed it with ashpat and pith, put the child in it and laid it on the reeds by the river's bank. May the Lord bless the reading of his word today in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, this is a story of a woman. Every woman is always happy when she's pregnant. She was happy. I will soon be having a baby. Praise the Lord. And at that time, she had that baby. But remember that in Goshen, at that time, a law was passed. Any household that has a child, if the child is a girl, the child can stay. But if this child is a boy, that boy must be killed. Amen?
Amen.
So this woman gave birth to the baby. And upon giving birth to the baby, the Bible says she looked at her baby and said, this baby is beautiful. Has anybody had a baby that you say the baby is not beautiful? But why did this particular woman say, my own is beautiful? And she hid this baby. She kept on hiding this baby. Perhaps she was using her breast to guard the baby's mouth. Perhaps she was using bottle to guard the baby's mouth. But there came a time when she could no longer hide this baby. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There came a time she could no longer hide this baby. Because any house, they hear congratulations. Immediately they enter, they say, congratulations on the baby. It's a boy. They take the baby to go and kill. But this mother noted, said, no matter what will happen, I will hide the destiny of this my child. I will keep this child. Now, brethren, please, it is not only about the children we carry for ourselves. That is motherhood. Some people are just particular about only my own children. That doesn't make you a mother. You are a mother when you see a child of another woman and you can take that child and bless as your own. You are a mother when you see children child, then you are a mother.
Yes.
Can you hide another child's destiny? Can you see another child going astray and carry that child? There's a boy which they sent to Nigeria recently. Now this boy was going to school, and another and his mom's friend was parked somewhere. And then she saw him with some kind of, some rough boys around a chicken shop. And she was wondering that at this time of the morning, what's this boy doing here? So when the boy saw the mom's friend, the boy now went to meet her and said, "Auntie, do not tell my mom what you have seen. If you do, these boys that are with me, they will come and kill your children." And then the woman left. She said, "My son, I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything." So she left. She was going, after about 3 days, she couldn't sleep. "If it was my son, what would it be?" So she called her friend and told her friend, "My friend, Orowa, if I come to your house, your son will know. I want us to meet somewhere. I need to tell you something." So she called her friend out and spoke and told the friend what she had seen and everything. Apparently, they were using the boy for drugs. So she now told her, "Now we have to work together as mothers. Your child is my child. Mine are yours. What we will do, we will make a way and then go to Nigeria for holiday, and we will keep him there for some time."
Yes.
So as we speak, the boy is home.
Yes.
If she had been quiet, one destiny will go out. Perhaps if we hear of the knife crime, it may be him. God forbid that it will come near our house, in Jesus' name. Because there are parents that even abuse their own children. This woman hit her child. They were killing other people's children, were they not? But this mother said, "No, my own will not be killed. My own, I can see beyond what he's not seen. I see something special about this child." Praise the Lord.
Amen.
A woman that is not a murderer, a mother that is not a murderer, knows how to hide the destiny of children. Are we hearing it?
Yes,
ma'am. When she saw this child, she could see potential. She said the child is beautiful. I've never seen a mother that gives birth to a child and says her child is not beautiful.
No.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
But this particular one said, "My own child is beautiful. I will hide him no matter what it takes. No matter what it takes." But in all of this, fathers, with no disrespect to you, sir, I humbly kneel. Where was Moses' father? Where was the father? Everybody have, we've all got our roles. I'm not here to say that fathers are not important. But where was the father? Perhaps the father will say, "This woman, you have started again. Now, you are hiding this baby. Before Pharaoh will now come and not just kill this baby, but all of us." Moses' father was never mentioned. The mother stood and hid her child for 3 months. Why? Because mothers are life givers.
Yes.
We give life to children. It does not matter the father, the daddy, or it's not irrelevant, but we are the life givers. There's something God has put in us that makes us different. We are the ones that know everything about the children. Praise God. We know their school. We go to their reports. We know their friends. We know where they go to. We know what they like to eat. Praise the name of the Lord. We will not be found wanting in the name of Jesus Christ. You are the one that knows the shoe size of your children. We know the clothes size that we know what they want. You know their favorite colors. Hallelujah. I was out with my son yesterday. My son wanted football trainers. And then he insisted we must go to, because his name is Jedidiah. He said we should go to JD's. I said, "JD is too expensive now." Eh? Okay, anyway, I convinced him. We went to Sports World. Do you know we were seeing all the things we were seeing there? We were seeing, my son said, "Mommy, this one is..." The Lord will bless us as mothers.
Amen.
of 3 months, the Bible says she could not hide him again. And I tell you, it's not by accident that today is the end of the third month. I decree and I declare. I decree and I declare. From today, your glory will not be hidden in the name of Jesus. At the end of the third month, at the end of the third month, she couldn't hide him again. The glory had to come out. When she couldn't hide him again, the Bible says she now went and built an ark. Ark represents covenant. Remember those that went into the ark of Noah? They were all saved. She knew, if I build the covenant for this child will be saved. Mothers have a way of projecting for their children. If I build a covenant for this child, my child will be saved. This mother made an ark and she put her child inside the ark. She made a covenant. She carried her child and put her child in the covenant. That is a mother. That is not a murderer. There are stories of women that are not even sick. They have nothing, but they just say, I don't want to even have my own. Let me go and bless children that have lost their mothers. Let me reach out to children. I know of a woman, sometime in Zaria, Hajia Gambo. That woman, she had just one child. But the woman has more than 70 children. She trained them. All of them went to school, went to university, Hajia Gambo. Only by herself. Praise the Lord. That is a mother. That is a mother. Mothers are always ready to take risks. Mothers, if you are a mother in the house, shout a big amen.
Amen.
And it should not just be about children that you carry in your womb. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let us open our Bibles quickly to the book of Genesis 27. It's a story we know, but we can take note of it so that we'll read them later. Genesis 27. The Bible says, Abraham, Isaac, was saying, my son, come, I love you. I'm perceiving in my spirit I may be living soon. Go and make food for me so that my mouth will not just bless you, my spirit will bless you. It's one thing when your mouth blesses, it's another thing when your spirit blesses. And the Bible says the mom was eavesdropping. Mommies, we know how we are. The mom was eavesdropping. Even though scripture, God had said, Jacob I love, Esau
I hate.
Why did the father not know that? Why did the father not know? The mother keyed into it. She heard the story. She heard that conversation. She said, okay, now your father wants to bless you. How? Now your father wants to bless you. Come, my son. Let me prepare something for your father. You take it to your father. Your brother has gone out. She told her son, she told Jacob, don't even bother to go into the woods. I will go to my kitchen and look for you. Again, mothers, as much as we love our children, let's not over pamper them. Let's not spoil them. The Bible tells us that we should chastise them. We should teach them the right thing so that instruction will not leave them when they are older. Yes. Amen?
Amen.
Don't over pamper them. And the father said, go and make food. The father said to one, go and make food for me, go and catch game. The mother said to the other, my son, don't go anywhere, stay. I have some secret in the kitchen. I have something. Then Jacob now told the mom, mom, I know me and Esau, I know we are twins, but there's so much difference between us. Esau is hairy, I'm not. And I know my father is a man of covenant. I know that when he speaks, God hears. If this my father should catch me that I lied, he will curse me, oh. Praise the in trouble. My own is finished. Now hear the reply of the mother. And the mother said, my son, don't worry. Let that curse be upon me if your father should catch you. A mother is a risk taker, especially when it comes to our children. The mother said, my son, don't worry. If I give you this thing and your father should catch you, I know he will curse you. But today, my son, I stand in the gap, I will take the curse for you. That is a mother. That is a mother. Let that curse be on me. I will take it. I know that if I ask many of us today now, how far can you go for your children? You say, I can do anything for my child. I can do anything, praise the Lord. But let's not over-pamper them. How far can you go for your child? This mother said, let that curse follow me. I cut you off from it. I know your father is a man of covenant. I know when he speaks, heaven hears too. But there is something about you. There is something I see in you that is different. I'm ready to take the curse for you to be blessed. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You must carry the spirit of a mother. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
What can you do for the church? You are a mother in the church. You are not just a mother to your household, to your children. You are a mother to the church. You are mothers to be, are mothers to the community. Wherever we go, that spirit of motherhood must come out. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And we know our firstborn children, our husbands, celebrate them in the house.
Hallelujah.
Let's look at the story of another mother. In the book of Matthew 20, from 20 to 24. Matthew 20, 20 to 24. Then the mother of Zebedee's sons came to him with her sons. A mother carried her children and went to Jesus. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
This mother did not leave her children. She was going to church or going to meet Jesus. She carried her two children and said, oh yeah, let's go. And came to him with her sons, kneeling down and asking something from him. And he said to her, what do you wish? And she said to him, Jesus, I'm on my knees now, please. I didn't come for my sake. Jesus, I didn't really come for you. I don't even want you to lay hands on me today. I don't want you to pray for me today. I have come for the sake of these my two sons today. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Grant that these two sons of mine may sit, one on your right hand and one on your left. In your kingdom. But Jesus answered and said, you don't know what you ask. Are you able to drink the cup that I am about to drink and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with? Now, it's not only the mother that answered. The Bible said, they, mother and children, said to him, we are able. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Mother and children said, we are able. So he said to them, you will indeed drink my cup and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with, but to sit on my right hand and on my left hand, it is for those that it is prepared for by my Father. Now, this is where I'm going to 24. And when the 10 heard it, they were greatly displeased with the brothers. A mother took her own children and went to Jesus and said, Jesus, I've seen all the miracles you've been doing. I've heard of your power. I've heard of the great things you do. And I'm perceiving in my spirit that your kingdom is the right kingdom. Now, I don't want to go to this kingdom by myself. I brought my children with you. Invariably, Maybe this woman came with her children and said, when we get to heaven, I want these two sons of mine to unseat the 24 elders with you. Let them move away for my children to sit. Let them inherit the kingdom. Now, the 10 heard, and they were angry. Where is their own mothers? It's a mother that came and took her own two and went. Where was your mother? Ask somebody sitting next to you. Are you a mother or a murderer? Many of us are coming to church. We don't carry our children to church. Many of us come to Sunday school service. We don't come. We don't come with our children. Many of us are coming to night vigil. We don't bring our children. The 10 were angry. Where was their mother? Or where are their mothers? They also have mothers. But this mother said, today, not today. My children, they must make heaven. I will intercede no matter what. When was the last time as a mother you woke up at midnight call to pray just for the children? We are talking to ourselves. When was the last time we stood to intercede? Father, I'm not here to talk about my job. I'm not here to pray for help. Father, I want to intercede for the children in the land. I want to intercede for my children's friends. I want to intercede for the children in school. I want to intercede for the children in the community. I want to intercede for the children in church. That is a mother. When was the last time you said, today, Lord, I am going on fasting to seek your face concerning the children? There's a lot of knife crime. January 18 last year, my cousin was stabbed and killed in this country. So I know the impact of it. When did we stand to intercede as mothers? Ask somebody next to you, are you a mother or a murderer? Ask them very well, though. If they are not responding, ask the next person. One day, picking my children, and the little boy was saying, Mom, and the mom said, oh, wait, 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 wait. And you know, I now want to go. I said, Mom, I'll beat up. I said, come, let's listen to my son. I said, you know, so that the boy will talk. I tell you, again, the boy will forget. He will forget. Man will hinder prayer, but the Bible says a woman can hinder her husband's prayer. Make up with her. So there is something about mothers that we need to preserve. God will help us in Jesus' name. Because of time, in 1 Kings chapter 3 again, in 1 Kings chapter 3, from 16 to 28, the Bible also tells us about this great king, King Solomon. King Solomon was sitting on his throne, Jeje, and that's how they brought matter before him. They're always in pairs. The woman came again, King, help me, King. The two of us, we had our children. Maybe same day. Maybe a week apart, but two of us gave birth, sha. King, while I was sleeping, while we were sleeping, that woman, she rolled on her own child and killed her child. Oh. She rolled, she overslept and slept and slept, and the baby was even crying. She didn't wake up. She slept and killed her child. So King would be like, if she killed her child, so why are you crying? King, the mother is, when she woke up and found her dead baby, she carried that baby and came and put it on my arm and took my own live baby. Mothers, some of us are oversleeping. We are sleeping and destinies are being killed. We are sleeping and children are being taken out of our lives. I know of a child. This child only went one day. The mother said she got work and walking, sent her child to one family for sleepover. The child came back and was never the same again. The child was never the same again. Some of us are sleeping too much. Some of us are working too much. Destinies are being taken. Life children are being taken out of us and dead destinies are being put. That will not be your portion in Jesus' name. And the woman, that means you were sleeping foolishly. And you killed your own child. So the child was crying and you still rolled on the child and killed the child. Now, this woman woke up, looked around and said, hey, I can see somebody even sleeping more foolishly than me. Let me go and give her this leftover and take what is life. Sometimes when we sleep, destinies are changed. Women of God, we need to wake up. And this is even the time we need the more to wake up. Wake up at night and intercede for your children. Wake up and intercede for your husband. Wake up and intercede for your marriage. Wake up and intercede for everything that is dear to you. Wake up and intercede for the children on the church. Wake up and intercede for their friends. This is the time, like never before. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Some people sleep, and things are dead. Wake up and decree and declare. Wake up and agree to some things and reject some things. Wake up and command some things into existence and annul some things. Why? Because the power is in your mouth.
Yes.
The power is in your mouth. The Bible says, verily, God said, verily I say unto you, what you say into my hearing, that very thing I will do it for you. Stand on the word of God. Sleep. And you are now coming to say, no, that's not my baby. But you overslept. What some people sleep, they can reprogram children. Do you know that? I was born a Muslim, I grew up a Muslim. A few years ago, the Lord called me, I gave my life to Christ. And I can testify from the Muslim side, it is done easily. Muslims play with stars a lot. If you find an alpha that does it, they do it a lot. So we need to be careful. If anybody says that it's not possible, it is a lie. And I can speak from where I know very well. Muslims do it a lot. All they need is just to do their sadaka. Once it is well recited and you eat those their buns of puff or akara, oh my goodness, the Lord will help his people in the name of Jesus. Just because mothers are sleeping, one is killed, another one is changed, that will not be our portion. Mothers, I pray, please do not look back. Do not look back. Let us look positively into the lives of our children. Amen?
Amen.
Positively. Yeah. When Lot was asked to come out with his family, and the mother looked back, and his wife looked back and turned to the pillar of salt, people of God, go and read what became of the children of Lot. How their lives turned. The kind of life they started living. Why? Because there was no presence of a mother in their life. They did not have a mother. Ask yourself, am I playing the role of a mother or am I a murderer? Am I sleeping and something is dying in my hand? Am I sleeping and the glory and destiny of loved ones are being changed in my hands? Are you like the mother of the sons of Zebedee that said these ones, they must inherit the kingdom of God? Are you like the mother of Moses that said, this one, I must hide this one until his glory comes out? Are you like Rebecca that said, let that curse come upon me. I stand in the gap for you as your mother. Whatever it will take for you to be blessed, I give it to you. In the name of Jesus Christ. The mother is to be honored. Praise the Lord. I see my time is up. But I'll just round up with this. Even on the cross of Calvary, when Jesus was on the cross, the Bible says that Mary was there. And another Mary that was her sister, and Mary Magdalene. People of God, where was Daddy Joseph? Daddy Joseph was not there. But Mary was standing there. And Jesus remembered, honor thy father and thy mother. And he said to the disciple that he loved, now please behold your mother. What Jesus is saying that from now on, I am moving from mortality into immortality. Begin to honor this woman. Take her as your mother. Take her as your mother. Praise the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Single mothers can bring. I've said single. Look at the life of Ishmael. A guy left the house with her son. Did she not bring up a good nation?
Yes.
Even a wealthy nation. Please, let us learn to intercede and stand for our children. Let us rise up to our feet. Let us rise up to our feet.
Yeah.
Let us rise up to our feet. Let us rise up to our feet. Praise the Lord. Begin to plead the blood of Jesus.